What up, Grinches? Tis the season to give fun, sassy gifts from PiperLou.com. Use the promo code SANTA for 40% off your purchase. And if you can't go through the holidays without your Jolly Juice to avoid a serious case of resting Grinch face, then PiperLou.com has the goods that you need. And get 40% off with the promo code SANTA. Snarky wine tumblers, sarcastic sweaters, and more. Shop PiperLou.com, promo code SANTA, for 40% off your order. That's PiperLou.com today.
On the air, online, from New York City, border to border, and coast to coast, you're connected with Tom Sullivan.
Yes, you are, and thank you for connecting. Welcome to the big radio show. It's, I almost said it's Friday, because I think it feels like a Friday for a lot of people. Anyway, welcome to the big radio show. Today is Wednesday, the 24th day of November, year of our Lord, 2021. My name is Tom Sullivan. And, man alive. Hey, Alexander the Great, did I tell you? I know you got in much earlier than I did, but man. It took me twice as long to come in today because everybody and their brother is on the road. And it took me a long time to get home last night. But I thought, okay, everybody's already going on the road to Grandma's house. And, they're out there right now. Some of you are sitting in your cars going, yeah, I know, you don't need to tell me. Why would you, I saw this family packing up their car. It was a guy, his wife, and two look like college-age daughters. And they've got an SUV, and they just had thrown all their luggage and everything else in the back of the SUV. And they're getting in their car and starting to leave. And I just thought of knocking on the window and going, why are you leaving now? Do you think maybe there's other people out there? Have you thought about that? Because that guy, once he got around the corner, it was going to be stop and go for however, wherever he was going. It is plugged out there. So, yeah, it's, they say today is the busiest travel day, but I don't think so. I think it's the busiest, airline travel day, but I think the busiest day is Sunday. Because there have been people, oh my gosh, this past weekend, I mean, we were out and it was just, the roads were jammed. So I think a lot of people have headed off to Grandma's house over the weekend, Saturday, Sunday, Monday, yesterday, and there's still a lot of people going. So it's busy out there, and that's just what it is. But the travel in most parts of the country looks like the weather's in pretty good shape. So enjoy. But be patient. It's busy, 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 busy. All right. What do we have on the plate for today? Well, I'm not surprised, but it did not take them long in the Ahmaud Arbery case to convict the three guys for murdering Mr. Arbery. I mean, it's a lot of various charges, and all three men were convicted on all of the charges. And so it was a lot to go through, but they did not waste any time. It probably took them most of the last 2 days, the jury, to just go through the paperwork. But there are 9 criminal indictments of each one of these three men, and there's one not guilty. There's a couple on Rhodey. He's the guy that came along. He's the guy who took the video. He's the guy who took the video, and he kind of was behind the other people, and they found him not guilty on a couple different charges. Same with Greg McMichael. But that's the dad, the younger redhead guy. He was found guilty on all charges. Let's go ahead and play the. Here's Travis McMichael as the jury reads the verdict. It's long, but here's what they had to say.
Verdict is as follows. In the Superior Court of Glynn County, State of Georgia, the State of Georgia versus Travis McMichael, case number CR000433. Jury verdict form. Count one, malice murder. We, the jury, find the defendant, Travis McMichael, guilty. I'm going to ask that whoever just made an outburst be removed from the court, please.
That was Arbery's father, by the way, who made the outburst.
Count two, felony murder. We, the jury, find the defendant, Travis McMichael, guilty. Count three, felony murder. We, the jury, find the defendant, Travis McMichael, guilty. Count four, felony murder. We, the jury, find the defendant, Travis McMichael, guilty. Count five, felony murder. We, the jury, find the defendant, Travis McMichael, guilty. Count six, aggravated assault. We, the jury, find the defendant, Travis McMichael, guilty. Count seven, aggravated assault. We, the jury, find the defendant, Travis McMichael, guilty. Count eight, false imprisonment. We, the jury, find the defendant, Travis McMichael, guilty. Count nine, criminal attempt to commit a felony. We, the jury, find the defendant, Travis McMichael, guilty.
Yep. So that's the guy, the younger guy. His father got almost, there was a few differences, but basically guilty. And also the other guy, Rhodey, who was their neighbor or friend, there was some question whether they would find him guilty. But I'll tell you what this, if you're involved in a crime, even though you're not the main perpetrator of the crime, but you're there, you're with them, you are in the automobile with them, you're the driver, whatever it might be, and they commit murder, you're guilty of it too. So all three of these men are, the sentencing is going to be coming up, but they're going to be, if not life, it'll be very close to life in prison. So are you surprised? I think a lot of people were kind of holding their breath because I did not follow it gavel to gavel. But of the videos that I saw, the video I saw and the other information that came in, it appeared to me that the evidence was overwhelming, that they trapped Arbery and shot and killed him. They were hunting him down. But this is what makes this, and all the, Reverend Al and Benjamin Crump and everybody else was there, and they made the point, the fact that this was what they considered to be what they used to call lynching, and that the fact that there were 11 white people, one black person on the jury, and in the Deep South, and they found these three men guilty of murder, plus was a sign that maybe things have changed, or was it a sign that the evidence was so overwhelming, or was it because this is something that they had tons of evidence against white people that killed black people back in the 1950s, and somehow, wink, wink, they got off. So was this a historical marker on let's push this racism business out of the way? And Al Sharpton even said it, that he says this proves that not all people, not all white people are racist. He could have been more delicate about it and say most white people are not racist. But he said not all white people are racist. So it's I'm curious if you have a take on all of this, because it was one of those where you kind of held your breath and thought, the evidence certainly appeared to be overwhelming that they trapped this guy and they killed him. But if they come back with, we don't see any guilt here, then it would probably put race relations back to where we were in 1955. So it's a momentous decision, but I don't think it was that difficult of a decision. It seemed like this is not one that you can hang your hat on and say, well, isn't this great, racism is now behind us. Let's go to cut 21. Jonathan Turley, exactly what we all saw. The video evidence was huge in this case.
This was a case which was the inverse of that. You know, the initial view was that this was probably privileged or self-defense, but then that changed when that shocking video was played to the public. The judge still has a role here to play. I believe under Georgia law, the judge still has to decide whether this will be a life sentence with chance of parole. That's largely going to be immaterial to the men because you have to, I believe, spend at least 30 years to become eligible. So given the age of the defendants, that may or may not be relevant. Certainly for Greg McMichaels, the father, it's unlikely to be a relevant consideration. But the judge will have to make that decision. And then the defendants will bring their appeals, and those will be based on a couple of legal decisions made by the judge, critical instructions given to the jury. Mm-hmm. But given the power of the videotape, again, it's hard to get something like this reversed, because the standard for the appellate court is whether this was a harmless error if there was an error at trial. Given that videotape, a lot of appellate judges are going to say that this really was an overwhelming case, so you're going to have to show something that it just clearly would have made a difference if it had gone the other way with the judge.
Yeah. So I want to get into the other issue about this. This trial almost never happened. It took a long time before there were even charges filed. And the district attorney, the former district attorney, has been booked on charges of mishandling of the case. Because if there wasn't that video, there's a lot of people are thinking this case never would have happened. And these three guys shot and killed Mr. Arbery, and nothing would have happened. So is it the good old boys club, or has that changed? Phone number here is 855-295-6600. Your reaction, 855-295-6600.
I'd like to nominate Tom Sullivan for the White House press secretary.
Please clap.
Yep. So we've got the Kyle Rittenhouse case done. Now we got the Ahmaud Arbery case done. And we were talking yesterday, just briefly, there's what is her name? Elizabeth Holmes, the woman who started Theranos and got billions of dollars. She's in the middle of her trial for basically stealing billions of dollars. So that's one that may pop up a little bit more. But these were the two big cases, and they're both behind us now. And old Ghislaine Maxwell next week, yes. But this one, I thought the Arbery jury may come back today, even though it's only been out just 2 days, because they want to go home for Thanksgiving. I'm sorry, but that has a motivator. Among juries, they want this behind them. Because, I mean, so they're having Thanksgiving gathering tomorrow. They're going somewhere. People are coming over. And you know the admonition from the courts are always, you cannot discuss not one word, not a syllable of this case. Do you understand? So it would have been one of the jury members would have had to sit in the corner and face the wall, not say anything, not participate in any conversation. 855-295-6600, Rich in Reno, Nevada. Hello, Rich.
Hey, how's it going? So
good.
I watched part of that trial on Fox News.
Yeah.
And it was the prosecutor interrogating the son. And I took away from that, he was extremely guilty just by his own account of the events that unfolded that day.
I saw part of that as well. And yeah, he seemed to be incriminating himself as he was answering her questions. She did a great job.
Very much so. I mean,
yeah.
You got to give the guy kudos for being honest, but at the same time, racist needs to be abolished in the nation. I'm not racist at all, but you can't go on a witch hunt for people either. But this guy and his cohorts deserve what they got, in my opinion.
It certainly looked like they were guilty. And to use, to borrow from Al Sharpton about basically calling this a modern day lynching, I can see why he would say that. I do.
I can too. I don't like Al Sharpton at all.
Yeah, I'm not a fan. But it does make you wonder in small pockets of this country, are there Klan memberships are still alive? And, you know, there are people of all stripes, and there are people out there that are extreme racist, and they don't think it's a problem to hunt somebody down from another race and kill them.
But the whole thing about that is that's not just white people. I've seen super racist black people.
Oh,
I've
sure.
seen super racist
sure.
Latinos.
Yes.
It's not just one race. It's all of them. We're all people. We're all here for the same reason. There's no reason to hate somebody because of their color.
So that's one of my questions when I get to the pearly gates. I got a lot of questions, Rich. I got a lot of them. And one of them is, why did you make people hate each other? Because I always take away those that one instruction. It's a simple instruction, but oh my gosh, love one another. And I'm going, really? Everybody? Really? What about that guy? So it's part of the human condition, because it's not something unique to the United States. It's not at all. There is racism in every corner of this globe. How did that happen? How does it happen?
I've lived in Alaska, California, Northern California, Oregon, Idaho, Florida. I live in Nevada. I've been here 20 years. There's racism and reverse racism in everywhere I've ever been.
Yeah. What are you, running from the law, or what are you, you just move a lot? Jeez.
I'm a proud American, and we have a beautiful country, and it was important for me to show my children that there's more to the world than what's outside your back door.
Yeah, nice. I'm teasing you. Very interesting. Rich, thank you. I do appreciate your call. And racism, it may be part of our DNA, but I think a lot of...
What up, Grinches? Tis the season to give fun, sassy gifts from PiperLou.com. Use the promo code SANTA for 40% off your purchase. And if you can't go through the holidays without your Jolly Juice to avoid a serious case of resting Grinch face, then PiperLou.com has the goods that you need. And get 40% off with the promo code SANTA. Snarky wine tumblers, sarcastic sweaters, and more. Shop PiperLou.com, promo code SANTA, for 40% off your order. That's PiperLou.com today.
It's that time of year. You can have leftovers. Again. Or you can close that fridge and open up the McDonald's app for something special, like your favorite crispy chicken sandwich. Now when you buy any crispy chicken sandwich on the McDonald's app, get another one for free, like the spicy crispy chicken sandwich. It's a deal so good, there won't be any leftovers. Ba-da-ba-ba-ba. Offer available through December 12th at participating McDonald's. Valid once a day. McD app download and registration required.
But
First Amendment 101. You're listening to Tom Sullivan.
Yes, you are. Thanks for coming by. So if you're just tuning in, the Ahmaud Arbery death trial, the three white guys in Brunswick, Georgia, all three of them convicted. This is the jury reading out the conviction of the father, Greg McMichael.
In the Superior Court of Glynn County, the state of Georgia, versus Greg McMichael. Case number CR 200433. Jury verdict form. Count one, malice murder. We, the jury, find the defendant, Greg McMichael, not guilty. Count two, felony murder. We, the jury, find the defendant, Greg McMichael, guilty. Count three, felony murder. We, the jury, find the defendant, Greg McMichael, guilty. Count four, felony murder. We, the jury, find the defendant, Greg McMichael, guilty. Count five, felony murder. We, the jury, find the defendant, Greg McMichael, guilty. Count six, aggravated assault. We, the jury, find the defendant, Greg McMichael, guilty. Count seven, aggravated assault. We, the jury, find the defendant, Greg McMichael, guilty. Count eight, false imprisonment. We, the jury, find the defendant, Greg McMichael, guilty. Count nine, criminal attempt to commit a felony. We, the jury, find the defendant, Greg McMichael, guilty.
Yeah, so that's eight out of nine guilties. Malice murder, he was found not guilty, but the rest of them were all guilty. Felony murder, a number of different counts, aggravated assault, et cetera, et cetera. Back to the phones we go. 855-295-6600. Betty in Oklahoma City. What do you make of this, Betty?
I'm really glad that turned out the way it did, because to me, they didn't have a right to kill that guy. And, I think they should have been convicted. That's how I see it. That's what I think and what I believe. And, stop any of the riots and protests and things, because I don't think anybody has a right to protest. And, America, a lot of the people in my age group, we're, kind of worried and troubled about what we're going to be leaving behind for our children and our grandchildren and great-grandchildren and all the other in-laws, and outlaws, as they say, whatever our family is, We're worried and concerned about what we're going to be leaving behind for them, I think all Americans, I don't care who we are, what race, color, creed, nationality, whatever, as long as you're an American, male, female, whatever. Now, I'm not talking about your color. I'm talking about being American. We need to pull together and put this country back on track, because what I'm seeing is, a lot of darkness and a lot of bad stuff happening, and people have a right to be afraid and scared, and they don't need to be mocked or made fun of or laughed at. They need their questions and concerns answered by leadership.
So let me try something on you. So if during your lifetime you've seen racism, it certainly hasn't gone away, but I would guess you might answer it has become better. It got less racism. And yet we're more divided on politics than we've ever been before. I mentioned this on Monday. It was the 58th anniversary of the assassination of John F. Kennedy. And to go back and watch some YouTube videos, primarily History Channel stuff, the people were devastated. They loved their president. They believed our government. They looked up to these people. What happened?
I think corruption and wickedness and greed and perversion. And, a lot of people are scared right now because they say the country is going to just wickedness and perversion and degradation. And, that it's not long before just dictatorship and tyrannical government sets in. I mean, people are scared to death out here, Tom. In my area, I don't, especially the older group, you know, and, you know, they, it's just like to them, Satan is loose and he's just raining havoc all over the world, not just this country. And I'm talking about people in my age group now, how they see things. I don't know about the rest of the country and the rest of the age groups, but in my age group, that's what they're seeing, just pure demonic, you know, corruption and greed and wickedness and just a reign of terror ahead of us. You know, I mean, I hope not. I hope I'm, you know,
Do you think it was always there, but we did not see it? But today, with 24/7 cable news, internet, whenever you want, information coming in on your watch. I mean, we are in an overload of information, and people are divided. I mean, there was a time, and it was maybe the McCarthy era would be the way to describe it, where communists they were going to root them out and put them in jail and lock them up. And today we've got members of Congress that on, and there's a story out of Seattle of a city council person there that's an avowed Marxist. We've got people that I'm sorry, but they are thinking along the lines that this country pretty much had no use for 50 years ago. What happened in the last 50 years? It's fascinating to watch, and it makes you wonder what's going to happen in the next 50. Which way is the pendulum going to swing?
I think, you know, like you said, racism's always been there, and it's always been between each and every race. I mean, it's not just white racism, it's black and all of it. And I think right now that, you know, the white race is the most hated race on the planet by all the other races. That's what I'm seeing and what I'm hearing. And it's bitter, and I mean, it's hatred, too. It's not just racism, it's hatred, very deep hatred of the white race is what I'm seeing. I think if we don't put
Go ahead.
I think if we don't pull this together and get out of this and stop the so-called media, the propaganda machine, and all those political powers just to gain power and just pervert and corrupt the planet and our country, we, the American people, and I mean all of us that love this country and love our descendants, we better get it together and quick.
I hope we do. I hope we do. Betty, I wish you a happy Thanksgiving. Have a great day tomorrow, and I know you're thankful for all your blessings. I think we all should be. Betty, thank you. Appreciate the call. Michael in California. Michael, welcome. You're on the Tom Sullivan Show.
Yes. Hello, Tom. First of all,
hi.
I wish you a happy Thanksgiving.
Same to you, sir.
Listeners.
Thank you.
You know, I'm a Democrat, but I've actually a little bit more lean towards independent. Some of you, you're not necessarily a Republican. But the response to what Betty's saying, or kind of dovetail on it, your question of where things went wrong after President Kennedy was assassinated.
Yeah.
A lot of it has to do with the fact that the average person, I'm born and raised in Sacramento, you know, a man of color, my family, we're middle class, done well, but it's a money issue. It's not necessarily, I've seen in my lifetime, I'm 65, I've seen in my lifetime that people of different backgrounds, of different racial backgrounds, can work things out as long as each one is getting some of that American dream. When things fall apart is when things become divided amongst races or people, even religion, is that when they're not able to get what the American dream has given to them. And a lot of it has to do with corporate greed in regards to the politicians, Republicans and Democrats.
I'm going to be up against a clock here in 20 seconds, but you're right. In recent times, a well-to-do white person lives next door to a well-to-do black person, lives next door to a well-to-do Hispanic person. It's all based on income. And I think you've touched on something, but I got to take a break. Michael, thank you.
Yes. This is the third time I've called. Should I hold or what do I do?
Mark O'Malley, he was, he's the big defense lawyer in Florida. He was the guy who represented George Zimmerman in the Trayvon Martin case. And Mr. O'Malley says this verdict not only gives justice for the family of Ahmaud Arbery, but also to the black community.
I'm glad that they took their time and that they walked through all of the verdicts the way they did, because now it can be accepted as a well-educated and well-thought-out verdict. And again, not only has justice been served for the Ahmaud Arbery family, but also for the black community generally and for us who live within the criminal justice system, because the opposite verdict, a hung jury or one where an acquittal came, would have been impossible to defend with the facts of this case.
Yeah. Mercedes Colwin, defense lawyer here in New York, says there's no way the defense could get around the videotape.
A videotape was so overwhelming and so much to overcome. The defense did what they could to try. Obviously, what defense attorneys will do, if the facts are terrible for you, you switch to the law. But at the end of the day, you had the jurors, that initial reaction to the videotape, like all of us had that same reaction, couldn't be overcome. No matter how much you tried to latch on to the fact that there is a civil arrest statute that, by the way, has been thus repealed. We know that immediately after Arbery, shortly after Arbery had been murdered, that law, the citizen's arrest law in Georgia, was repealed, and repealed for a good reason, to avoid a circumstance like this happening in the future. And the fact that when you couldn't have the jury be swayed in any way because of the law, then of course you had the judge's instruction regarding citizen's arrest, it really became pretty improbable for the defense to take a win. Frankly, this seems like the right result.
Yeah. So the justice system is on trial every time there is a trial. And the former district attorney in that part of Georgia has been booked on charges, this is about a month ago, on charges linking her to alleged mishandling of the case. The former Glenn County District Attorney, Jackie Johnson, turned herself in to the sheriff's office after a grand jury returned an indictment on counts of obstruction and violations of oath by a public office. By a public officer. So not only obstruction, but she had an oath. This is about a month ago when this all went down. So she was released from the detention center on a $10,000 bond. State prosecutors alleged that she used her position to delay the arrest of these three men who chased and killed 25-year-old Arbery. She was the county's top prosecutor when Arbery was fatally shot in 2020, February, before the pandemic hit. February of 2020, one of the armed men, the father that pursued him along with his son and the neighbor, the father had worked as an investigator for Ms. Johnson. So the Georgia Attorney General, a guy by the name of Chris Carr, sought the indictment. He's a Republican, and requested an investigation of possible misconduct by local prosecutors who failed to bring charges in the killing. Johnson insisted that she did nothing wrong, saying she immediately recused her office from handling the case because Greg McMichael had been an employee. The parents and their attorneys of Ahmaud Arbery have accused her of trying to help the young man's killer avoid prosecution. I remember that was the accusation at the time, that she knew the father and she did everything she could to keep him from being charged. So if she's convicted, she will go to jail for 1 to 5 years for the violation of her oath of office. The obstruction charge is a misdemeanor, punishable by up to 1 year in jail. The indictment says she violated her oath by showing favor and affection to Greg McMichael and failing to treat Armaud Arbery and his family fair and with dignity. It also says she obstructed police by directing that Travis McMichael should not be placed under arrest. So she's going, may be going to jail. She gets her day in court. Philip in California, thanks for waiting. Philip, welcome. You're on the Tom Sullivan Show.
Thank you for having me on.
You bet.
I just wanted to say I think that it's important that we stop this kind of thing from happening in the future, but I don't think that both sides are being told in a way that lets people empathize with what really happened. Does that make sense?
Not really. There was a multi-week trial where both sides were represented and called witnesses. They certainly gave their side of the story, both sides.
That probably helps. It was televised the same way the Rittenhouse trial was, too, right?
Right.
I didn't watch
right.
it. I apologize.
Yeah. No, I didn't either.
I think that it's important to realize that I think the motivation of these guys was that there was someone terrorizing their neighborhood and basically jogging to pick targets, and they went and found this guy. And I guess this is before all the BLM riots, so maybe there wasn't all the defunding the police. But if police are defunded, then you'll get more of these things happening. And on the other side, if you empathize with the guy, he's just going out for a jog. He goes and looks at some construction, which is a nice place to go on a jog. Goes back, and then people with guns show up and try and arrest him. And then he tries to defend himself. In his mind, I'm sure he thought he was defending himself, and they shoot him.
Let me ask you something.
I think the term for that is murder.
Yeah. Have you ever walked around in a home under construction? Ever had one in the neighborhood that was under construction?
Yeah, once or twice.
I mean, I have. Somebody's building a home down the street around the corner, and we go out for a walk, and you kind of poke around and look in the house, and, you know, they're framing the thing, and you look, oh, so this is where a two-story looks like a bedroom over here, and there's where the kitchen's going to go, and I don't know. It's a curiosity thing.
The inner workings. Yeah, it's the inner workings of how everything, like how to build a house. You look around you, it's always interesting to see how stuff is made, right?
Yeah.
So, especially when he's not stealing anything, the guy shouldn't have been shot for this, unquestionably. But I think that it's important going forward that we understand that the motivation was not these guys just wanted to go out and lynch a black man or, you know, the modern day version of that, shoot him. I think it's important to understand that they wanted a neighborhood criminal to be stopped, and the police weren't catching the guy, so they took it upon themselves. And I think that it's important to the conversation going forward to make sure that this type of thing never happens again, regardless of motivation, shouldn't have happened. I think it's important to stop it from happening, that we understand that if you defund the police, make it so the police don't show up, make it so that there's not enough police to show up, and then no one shows up to stop someone who's terrorizing a neighborhood, or if the police are ordered not to do anything, like we saw over the last year, it's not going to stop in the future, right?
Yeah, I hear what you're saying, and there are never going to be police everywhere that can stop a crime instantly. So most people pick up the phone and call 911. But I hear your point, Phil, about if the police never show up, you get frustrated, and the danger is you take the law into your own hands.
What up, Grinches? Tis the season to give fun, sassy gifts from PiperLou.com. Use the promo code SANTA for 40% off your purchase. And if you can't go through the holidays without your Jolly Juice to avoid a serious case of resting Grinch face, then PiperLou.com has the goods that you need. And get 40% off with the promo code SANTA. Snarky wine tumblers, sarcastic sweaters, and more. Shop PiperLou.com, promo code SANTA, for 40% off your order. That's PiperLou.com today.